Happy Friday, everyone. Welcome to the TGIF Report. I'm Mike Moliterno. We have got a special treat for you today. As you may or may not know, my work wife, Jeremy Lydic, has left the Business Journal after many years to relocate to another part of Ohio with his actual wife. In addition, it is 4 years next week since we went on one of our favorite assignments of all time for the Business Journal, an in-depth look at Ohio's Grand River Valley Wine Trail. So, in honor of Jeremy, we're going to play the first of several videos that came out of that fateful trip. In late May, orders came down that it was time for reporter Jeremy Lydic and I to head out on assignment, 2 days in northeastern Ohio's wine country. We were tasked with getting a snapshot of the growing industry and staying out of jail. Somehow, against all odds, we managed to do both. We began our trip at Marco Vineyards, which has 15 acres of grapes and produces about 1,500 cases of wine per year.
You can see the wine in here.
Arnie Esterer opened Marco in 1968 when he began growing European vinifera grapes instead of the Concord and Niagara varieties native to the area.
But we want to make a distinctive wine that reflects what this region is.
The grapes allowed Marco to produce wines such as Pinot Noir, Riesling, and Pinot Grigio.
By using them, we enter the world market in competition or in trying to show what this region can do with the wine grapes that grow in the climates that's similar to what's in Europe.
But Esterer says the variety that can really put the region on the map is Chardonnay.
We think we can do the best in Chardonnay. We can beat California in white wines.
And it tells you that this was a light toasted barrel with toasted heads. The wood is 3 years air dried.
Esterer ages all his Chardonnay and Pinot Noirs in oak barrels, pretty typical compared to what the next winery on our list was doing. So we headed off to see it for ourselves. We arrive at Lorello Winery in Geneva, which produces around 4,000 cases per year. Lorello has 8 acres of vineyards where they grow Concord, Catawba, Chardonnay, and Riesling grapes, as well as some high-end reds, says General Manager Danielle Di Donato.
I've been in this business since I was 13 years old, and it's been pretty cool to me to be able to see the way the wine has evolved and how good the winemakers around here are getting at what they're doing. This is our barrel room.
The barrel room is where they age their red wines as opposed to the stainless steel tanks they use for their whites. However, one blend gets an aging process all its own.
We just recently started making a red wine that we age in bourbon barrels, so the finish on the wine has a bourbon taste. It's awesome. It's our Cosmo. It's a red blend, and that's been a huge seller for us.
Sounded to us like a tasting was in order, so we got a couple of flights.
Cab Franc. That's another red.
A quick selfie for Instagram, and it was time to taste. We started the next day bright and early at Grand River Cellars in Madison. Grand River sits on 53 acres, four of which produce grapes.
We produce over 10,000 gallons of wine.
The main dining room is here.
Cindy Lindberg is the owner.
We really focus on the food and the wine and the fun. We have a full menu and we offer 20 different wines, anywhere from sweet to dry.
The tasting room walls are lined with the many awards Grand River wines have won. Lindberg says their success is due in part to the region's climate.
We are actually part of what is known as the Great Pinot Belt, which is an area of land that actually spans the entire globe. And that's where it is said to be that the best Pinots in the world are grown. And we're part of that. And that, when you talk about Pinots, you're not just talking about Pinot Grigio and Pinot Noir, but Pinot Chardonnay is also part of that.
Drinking wine, sporty oldie, drinking wine. Wah, wah. Drinking wine, sporty oldie, drinking wine. Wah,
wah. Our final stop was to one of the largest wineries in the area, Ferrante Winery and Restaurant in Geneva. When we arrived around midday, they were just finishing up bottling. Workers at Ferrante bottle about 2,000 gallons of wine per day to keep up with the 55,000 cases they'll sell every year. Ferrante sits on 40 acres of vineyards and has been in business since 1937. Carmel Ferrante is the third generation to run the business.
The Ohio industry has really exploded.
Ferrante says she's starting to see more demand for drier wines as opposed to the sweeter varieties, and that Ohio wine drinkers are becoming more knowledgeable.
We would like to educate and expand people's palates with food and wine. I think the more we educate our consumer, and the more knowledgeable they get and understand where the grape's grown and why it is, how to read the labels, you know, and they understand what they're drinking, then they can actually have fun with it and share it with their family and friends and make it a tradition in their lives.
After that, it was time to say goodbye to our new friends and head back to the valley. In tomorrow's Daily Buzz, we'll focus on how the region's wineries are working together to create a tourist destination on par with California's Napa Valley. And on Wednesday, we'll return to Ferrante Winery to show you how they take advantage of Northeast Ohio's winters to create ice wine. And links to all of those additional videos are available in the description below, so you can check them out as well. Have a happy, safe weekend. I'm Mike Moliterno.
717 Credit Union. Business services designed to meet your daily needs. Commercial loans, business deposits, merchant and payroll services. 717 Credit Union. It's knowing you were treated right every time.